The Thomas and Mac always puts on a show when the Rhino Rebels are at home. Whether the Rebels perform well has been another story with a losing record in conference play at home. They were 1-point underdogs for this game. Lil Jon was on the floor and opened the ceremonies. They got off to a great start with an 11-point lead, but by the half, the score was tied at 38. As usual, top-notch journalists were in attendance, and I was lucky enough to get a few to speak with us.
Hi, Casey Carpenter here tonight at Thomas & Mack, where UNLV is hosting San Diego State, and they're at a tough time with the conference play. What do you think of the runs
tonight? It's like it is weekend, week out for this day. They got to play better for their defense. They got to stop the dribble, and that's really key. They can play better defense and beat this game. But, Brandon McCoy's playing well. Was he having 11 points in the half and 4 rebounds, I think, here in the half. So, Brandon McCoy's playing well. Yeah, but they're going to play a little smarter.
Chris Matthews from Channel 8. Thank you so much.
You got it. What are you saying?
I'm with Kevin E. Martin here, also from Channel 8 tonight. Kevin E., what do you think the odds are on the UNLV beating their underdog record here tonight?
Well, they started out hot, but what I'm not impressed with is the second chance points that they're going to be in the rebounds. They're getting out-rebounded inside 21-13 right now, and SDSU is extremely undersized. They need to tighten up in the paint and see. I mean, honestly, I think if Shakur Justin and Brandon McCoy can step it up, then I think they'll be fine.
The game was close in the second half. Javon Moore for three put the Rebels up 48-41, but the Aztecs caught up. Tervell Beck to Javon Moore for two and a foul. That put the Rebels up 50-48. A missed free throw shot rebounded by Tyrell Beck with a quick toss to Brandon McCoy for an easy two, and the tied up game was over from there. Clyborne to Hardy to Johnson. McCoy with the pick. Johnson to Clyborne for two. Jerome Hensley's missed three is recovered by Shakur Justin and catches Jordan Johnson on a fast break for two. Score 60-53. The crowd and fans were over 11,000 strong and they were excited. Mike Longy gave a moment and his take on the game.
So I'm here with Mike Longy right now. Mike, what are your thoughts on the Rebels and their losing record here at home during conference?
Well, that's not good. But I think we're going to get a win tonight.
Yeah? McCoy's gonna pull it off.
Oh, he shouldn't be in there at the end. Maybe John.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Mike.
Chris Clyborne working the clock to a double team McCoy, back to Hardy for three, and the momentum didn't stop. Johnston finding Shakur Justin for an easy reverse, put the Rebels up by 10. Justin drives and makes 2 points look easy. Malik Pope responds with a three to keep the Aztecs in the chase. With a turnover created by Max Montana, the Aztecs capitalized with three from Devin Watson. That put them within 5 points within 5 minutes left in the game. The last 2 points were from Johnson, who worked the clock for a jumper. Final score, 88-78. The Rebels' 11-game losing streak ends, leaving Coach Menzies relieved and focused.
It's an incredible relief when you win, but it's not as exciting as you would want it to be because you got to move on to the next game, you know. But I'll save this one for the evening, and we'll start getting ready for the next game shortly.
The Rebels host San Jose State next week, back here at the Thomas and Mack. For the Rebel Report, this is Casey Carpenter.